Hey guys, so I decided to do another one of these short videos. So here we're going to take a tour of what is right now my Splash Tetra tank. This tank's had many different inhabitants. I've had it set up for probably 3 years now. and it's had the puffers in it, it's had guppies in it, but currently it has a group of Splash Tetras in it. Some Amano shrimp. That Amano shrimp is currently buried, so she has eggs, but those will not hatch because this is an actual freshwater system and they need brackish to breed. So I also have this group of Splash Tetras that Amber from Big City Bettas purchased for me while we were at the Big Fish deal at the beginning of last year. I've been obsessed with this species ever since I found out that they actually jump out of the water to put their eggs on a leaf. They jump out together and then the male like splashes them to keep them wet until they hatch, so I'm hoping I can do that. I also have a group of Trilineatus corys in here that I got from, I believe, Bob Hargis from our Circle City Aquarium Club. And those Trilineatus corys don't lay very many eggs when they actually spawn, so I've only ever been able to pull a few eggs, and I've raised up one baby, but I haven't really put a ton of effort into breeding them. Also in this tank, there are about six autosynclus. I have had these autosynclus for probably 3 years, and I love them. They do a good job of cleaning. So let's talk plants. Plants in this tank, currently we've got a ton of Heuteroi crypts that are growing out and recovering from the puffers being in here and causing algae. We also have a Rose and Maiden crypt that I am trying to grow out that was a little tiny piece that I found off my other big ones. So I put it in there to grow out, and then all the rest of this is Jungle Val, which is currently trimmed up real nicely because these guys got a water change yesterday. And then you'll see some little remnant pieces of guppy grass from when this tank was filled with guppy grass at one point. If I don't get that out, it will try to take over, but, you know, we'll see. And there's also, you know, some algae, but that happens. Welcome to freshwater fish keeping. We sometimes have algae. Okay, so as far as equipment on this tank, this is one of the only tanks that I run with all the equipment on it. So it has a hang-on-the-back filter with filter floss in it. It has a big heater in it, and it also has an airline in it. Most of my tanks are run no filter, no air, no nothing, but this one is one of the oldest ones I ever set up, and I had put those on there at the beginning of my fish keeping foray. So let's feed these guys, and I'll show you that they have absolutely no food response. They are shy fish, they don't like to come out, but eventually after a couple of minutes you'll start to see things like this where they're darting around in the plants trying to hide and eat. So I love them. I hope you did too. I hope you enjoyed this video, and live your best life.